Hi, my name is Varun Dwaraka. I'm a bioinformatics analyst here at UC San Francisco. And my current project that I'm working on is trying to understand the cause or the genetic causes for idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis, which is a lung disorder.
Varun Dwaraka is making strides in an interdisciplinary medical field towards a cure nobody has yet set eyes on. His expertise and passion are critical to the team he has attached himself to, and he is hopeful for a discovery soon. But he didn't start out as one might expect. Let's hear his story.
To be quite honest, I had an interesting way. I really just despised science when I was growing up, which was interesting because I come from a family of scientists, mathematicians, and doctors specifically. But for some reason, when I went through the entire route of like high school, I took an AP bio class. And I started seeing science in a way that I became a little bit more fond of it. And so when I went into college, I naturally picked up biology because that was one of the classes I took as an AP prerequisite. When you looked at molecular biology, you saw all these components working together with the CPU being, you know, the nucleus, or if you look at the organismal level, the brain. So just being able to translate the cell into a machine and seeing my body as kind of like a machine, that was kind of interesting to see it that way. I'm doing mostly bioinformatics research here. I think what got me here was my love for computers. I've been using a computer since I was a little kid, so being able to use a computer to solve a biological question, that seemed pretty cool to me. Right now, I'm actually working on a project for SarahTuttleton-Arron, and we're trying to understand the genetic makeup for a specific disease called idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis, which is kind of like a thickening of your lung tissue. Researchers haven't been able to find a cure for this disease, and so I'm trying to see if I can find any genes that are specific for it, so you can use those genes to pretty much cure it. The computer helps. Understanding a little bit of programming definitely helps. Understanding the computational tools, such as finding a program that somebody else wrote and understanding how to use it, it really does help. I've been going through the entire process and pipeline currently, so I haven't really found anything yet, but I'm kind of hopeful. Right now, like I said, I'm just trying to understand the genetic makeup for this disease that I'm studying. And it's a lot of going through Excel sheets, a lot of trying to understand what the data means in the biological context. And that's what separates us from computer scientists, is that we have a background in biology, but we're trying to use computer science as a tool in order to go through the data. Because in this day of age, we have a ton of data, but not many people understand how to use the tools that would make looking through the data easier. To be quite honest, it's a lot of, you know, you fail a lot, but at the same time, for me personally, it keeps you going. It gets you going a lot. Yeah, I like the challenge, and I think that's ultimately why I wanted to become a researcher and why I am, I guess, a researcher. As cliche as it sounds, don't give up. Times will be tough, especially when you're going through the entire path, but if you keep at it, if you keep studying, keep working hard, I found out that if you keep working at it and keep studying hard, you will definitely succeed. You will be able to go wherever you want and do whatever you want. It just takes a lot of hopeful thinking and a lot of just staying on the path.